Malik.
Saya Rendra dari Trenggalek. Saya mualaf, saya dulu Kristen. Alhamdulillah sudah banyak menjalankan sunnah. Yang saya mau tanyakan sama Dr. Jagir, yang pertama, apakah penganut Injil waktu yang dulu itu bisa masuk surga? Terus yang kedua, gimana saya cara meyakinkan kepada keluarga saya, terutama kepada keluarga besar ibu saya, karena masih banyak mayoritas yang masih Kristen, bahwasanya memang Injil yang sekarang itu sudah melenceng jauh dari yang dulu. Terima kasih. Ya. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. His name is Rendra from Trenggalek. He was Christian and he practices Islam now, and he is asking question. Is the people following the original Bible, the original gospel, which has not been corrupted, can be in Jannah? This is the first question. And the second, how to convince my family to be Muslim? The second, how to convince my family that Islam is, how the method to convince my family to be Muslim?
Saya menjelaskan Injil sekarang itu sudah melenceng jauh dari yang
cukup,
dulu.
Cukup. Yeah. The last two questions. The first question is that he's asking that can he believe in the previous scriptures that were revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And the second question is how can he convince his parents regarding to accept Islam? As far as the answer to the first question is concerned, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the glorious Quran in Surah Ra'd, chapter number 13, verse number 38, لِكُلِّ أَجَلٍ كِتَابٍ. For each period we have sent a book. By name, four revelations are mentioned in the glorious Quran. The Torah, the Zabur, the Injil, and the Quran. The Torah was the wahi, the revelation that was given to Moses, peace be upon him. The Zabur was the wahi, the revelation that was given to David, peace be upon him. The Injil was the wahi, the revelation that was given to Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. And the Quran is the last and final revelation that was revealed to the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So by name, four revelations are mentioned in the glorious Quran. But there were several other revelations that were revealed. For example, Sufa Ibrahim, the scrolls of Prophet Ibrahim. But we Muslims, we need to believe in all the revelations that were revealed before the glorious Quran, and we need to believe also in the glorious Quran. But all the revelations that were revealed before the glorious Quran, they were only meant for their people and for that time. But today we have to follow the last and final revelation, that is the glorious Quran. So all the previous revelations that were revealed, they were time bound. They were only meant for that time. But we Muslims, we have to believe in those revelations also, but we have to believe today in the last and final revelation, that is the glorious Quran. And when you're doing dawah to the Christians or people of other faiths, for example, the Hindus, when you're doing dawah to them, it is mentioned their scriptures regarding the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today's talk was religion in the right perspective. It showed the various major world religions, and it is mentioned in these religious scriptures they have to believe in only one God. And I've given a talk on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the various world religious scriptures, which prophesizes in the Bible, in the Hindu scriptures, regarding the coming of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. I would like to give you one verse. It's mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 16, verse number 12 to 14. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, I have many things to say unto you, but ye cannot bear them now. For he, when the Spirit of truth shall come, he shall guide you unto all truth. He shall not speak of himself. All that he hears shall he speak. He shall glorify me. So Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is talking about a prophet to come, and that is Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. It is mentioned in the book of Isaiah, chapter number 29, verse number 12. The book is delivered to thee, saying, read this, pray thee, and he said, I am not learned. So even Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he prophesies about the coming of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And whatever book is revealed to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, we need to follow that book. But for today, for us Muslims, our guidance, it is the glorious Quran. I hope that answers the question.
Dijelaskan bahwa
okay, the second part of the question is how can you convince your parents regarding them to accept Islam? Brother, if you heard today's talk, it talked about religion in the right perspective. That is the concept of God in the major world religions. So you should tell, if your parents, they are Christians, you should tell them that there is not a single unequivocal statement, not a single unambiguous statement in the complete Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, himself says, I am God, or where he says, worship me. And Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he never claimed divinity. There are several references mentioned in the Bible wherein Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he has never claimed divinity. In fact, he said, it is mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 5, verse number 30, I can of my own self do nothing. As I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just, for I seek not my will, but the will of my Father. Same thing is mentioned in the Hindu scriptures, that you have to worship only one God, who has got no images. It is mentioned in Yajurved, chapter number 32, verse number 3, Natasipatima Asti, of that God, there is no image. So in this way, you can convince your non-Muslim parents to accept Islam, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide your parents to Islam. I hope that answers the question.
Terima kasih. Bisa mohon izin untuk bersalaman dengan Dr. Zakirnek.
He asked permission to shake your hand. Yes, come. Maju, silakan ke depan.
Can we have the next question from the sister side? Any non-Muslim sister, revered sister? If not, then any Muslim sister who's in the queue?